But the interesting thing that we can do with something like NVVP is we can go in and we can analyze the program. So this is going to run the program many times. It's collecting a bunch of statistics about the program. It's averaging them together. And now that we've done this analysis, we have a lot more information about these kernels. So if I click on this, you see I have more statistics over here. And the one I want to highlight for you is the global load efficiency, which tells us how efficient our global loads were. In other words, of all of the bytes that we fetched with each memory transaction, how many of them were actually useful? 100% looks pretty good. That's what we would expect from fully coalesced accesses. The global store efficiency, so now our stores to global memory, which in our case is writing the output matrix, achieved 12.5%, and that's pretty wretched, right? And that's again what we would expect from having inspected the code. Our total DRAM utilization is down at 7.6%. Again, remember, this is not going to exactly match what we calculated outside the profiler, but we can tell that there's a problem. That was the parallel per row kernel that only had a single thread block. We can see that the parallel per element kernel doesn't do much better. It has slightly higher global store efficiency, very slightly higher DRAM utilization. So we've still got this problem. Our problem is clearly our ability to write to the output matrix is hampered. We're not achieving the bandwidth that we ought to. As I said before, I'm not intending to go through all of the many, many things that you can analyze in NVVP. I'll pull it up once or twice again in the course of this lecture to just illustrate that there are tools to help you figure out what's going wrong. You can see, in fact, that down here, it's actually analyzing the program for you and giving you some suggestions, you know, saying, look, the multiprocessors in your program are mostly idle. You're not getting a lot of work done for the total amount of time that this program runs. And your total compute to memcopy efficiency is low. In other words, you're not doing a lot of computation given the amount of time that you spend doing memcopies. Here's the memcopies in our timeline. You can see that we spent, you know, 2.6 milliseconds copying information in, and then, you know, 8 milliseconds processing it, and then another 2.6 milliseconds copying it out. So it warns us, hey, the total compute to memcopy efficiency is low. So these are really useful tools. You should use them. You should know about them. But we're not going to rely on them too much in this class because our point is to teach you how to reason about things from first principles. So our problem is bad coalescing on the right to the output matrix. What can we do about that?